nitakuwa mwana kwa Mungu huko pasipa kuliinua jina lako juu ya majina yote, mfalme tawala na milki. Kwa maana kwa hakika wewe ni Mungu usiyebadilika, Bwana. Twanyenyekea mbele zako tukiliinua jina lako Bwana mahali pa juu zaidi katika kusanyiko hili, tukiomba ya kwamba Bwana uwezo wako uzidi kuwa pamoja nasi, na zaidi ya yote tunapo kusikia ukinena nasi Mfalme, unene nasi kwa njia mwafaka, ili tuweze kufika mahali pa kuelewa vema lililo kusudi lako na neno la siku hii. Na sifa zote ndio tukufu ni kwako, pokea sifa zote tunapomwalika Roho wako Mtakatifu aweze kutembea pamoja nasi, kwa jina la Yesu Kristo tumeomba na kuamini. Amen. You may have your seats. Nabiki kwa sababu wanyama kwa kata
nimeweza kutokea kwa nasi nijapato
disposition by the time kwa kike wakati wa kuwa hili na ya atakuwa ni spiritual bulldozer. Every time we run elections, they are happy, quiet.
They had heard the reports about the resurrection of Christ. They have heard the women. They had heard the apostles who went to confirm. So all these messages, they had them. Yet, they were discouraged. Yet, they were discouraged. This thing was a matter of problem. It was a matter.
They were discouraged. Why? God didn't do what he expected him to do. Hello? Number one, walitaraji ya kwamba Yesu atakuwa a military kind of a person to deliver the Jews from the Roman authority. Awina? Walifikia Yesu atakuja kama mwanajeshi ili aweze kuokoa Wayahudi kutokana na hali waliokuwa kifigiliwa na utawala wa Warumi. But Jesus didn't come that way. Ask your neighbor, how do you expect Jesus to appear?
How do you expect Jesus to appear?
Amen. You'll be frustrated when you expect him to appear in a particular way, he appears in a different one. You'll be frustrated. Are we there? Now, they saw the glory of the kingdom, but they failed to understand its suffering. Walitazamia utukufu wa ufalme wa Mungu, lakini hawakuangalia the suffering of the kingdom. Why? God's kingdom is a matter of glory, but before glory, there is some suffering. There is some suffering. Now, as a church, some of us are living in fear. But do you think we have a reason of fear? I don't see any more. God is blessing us. He's increasing us. He's ministering to our needs. When we pray, he hears us. We are witnesses of the marvelous and wonderful things that is being upon us. And for this reason, we need not to fear. We need not to fear. Why do you think that Mungu tuliaomba tukamwambia tupe hela za kukamilisha kanisa akatupa? Nani amekuambia tukimwomba kwa sababu ya mali ya taifa hata sikia?
Tasikia.
Ah. Amina. Kuna watu kadhaa ambao tumeombea wakiwa wagonjwa, huku wakawapona. What tells you that the same God we pray shall not hearken to our prayer of peace in this republic? We've been praying for them, our kids.
And today I'm so happy when you see the mommy, the confidence of standing there and singing. When you see mama pale sija praise. When you see mama pale sija praise. Unaweza simama hapo umepanga speech. Ukisimama hapo ni evaporate. Mbaki ukishangaa haiyai. Na nilikuwa nataka kusema nini? Hello? Back at the campus, we had a professor. Siku moja akapewa nafasi ya kwenda kusoma somo, a reading. Department yao ndio ilikuwa na Sunday hiyo siku. Prof akasimama pale, kuangalia watu hivi na kuangalia nyuma kuona msalaba. He was like, oh my God. So this is not just a lecture. This is not. Anza kutetemeka. Atetemeka akitoa anaona tetemeka inaanguka. So itabidi akasaidiwe kusoma nini. Lakini ukimkuta lecture hall, ako juu sana. Hello? So study here, it involves God. It involves God. And I've seen God work miracles in our midst. Are we there? Now, the local disciples kept on talking. The father, he went away from the throne. Word of God. Leopas anazidi kuuliza Yesu na Yesu anatembea nao. Kwani ni wewe peke yako ukieni Jerusalem? Kama mtu mwenye anaweza kuuliza, kwani wewe ujui Kenya? Leopas anauliza Yesu, kwani ni wewe peke yako ukieni Jerusalem? Ujui chenye kimetendeka? Just like some of us are asking. Kwani wewe ujui Kenya? Kenya iko na nini? Hello? So this was here, and I'm working on the three Kenya in a reputation of world famous athletes. House of our servants, rugby. And a police in Kenya, and you began a chat. Look at your name, but police in the joke, Kenya. The police in the joke, Kenya. So this could also have a pump one next week. Kwa sababu gani? Next week kutakuwa na nini? Na vita. Let me ask you, if the church can start and declare that next week kutakuwa na vita, sasa unaona kama hutani kama? There is power in our conversations. There is power in our conversations. Are we there? Mwetu shidi ya kanisa ni ya kofa. There is something that I loved. Kulikuwa na jamaa mmoja ako na baa kubwa sana. Ilikuwa opposite kanisa. So wale watu wa kanisa wakaanza kuomba. Wakiomba Mungu washughulike, awaondolee ile baa. Wanaomba Mungu tuondolee hiyo. Hawasemi ifanyike nini, wanaomba Mungu tuondolee hiyo. Hiyo baa. So watu wa kanisa wakaomba kwa muda mrefu. Mmoja ile baa ikachomeka yote. Tuashis. Mwenye baa akaenda kushtaki kanisa kwa koti. Enda akasema mimi bayangu ilichomwa na maombi hilo kanisa. Kanisa ika plead not guilty. Kanisa ika plead not guilty. Wakasema sio sisi. Mwenye maa anasema maombi yenu ilifanya bayangu. Kanisa ninasema sio sisi. Sawa jaji akasema today I have a very difficult situation. Yeye hapa yeye who believes in the prayers of a church, and a church which does not believe in our prayers. Have you got the church? That's how the church is going to be here. That's how the church is going to be. How do I keep the ruling? Because here, I have a situation. A heathen who believes that the prayers of a church has destroyed his business premises, and a church which does not believe in the power of their prayers. So where do you stand? Though you are discouraged. Are you part of the church that never believes in the power of their prayers? Are you part of that? Naona wengine wanataka kusema no au yes. Just look at your neighbor. Muulize, where do you stand?
Where do you stand?
Are you a church that believes in prayers?
Are you a church that believes in prayers?
Or you just pray for the sick?
Or you just pray for the sick?
Najua kuna watu wanaopanga tu ni kuna huko. Ah. Si kuna watu wanaopanga tu kuna huko. Kwa sababu tulikuta kukiomba baba yetu aliye mbinguni. So hata sisi tukisikia baba yetu na yeye tunaendelea. Mbele na kuja. Wale wote kwenye grupu. For the sake of it. For the sake of it. Ni kama watu wengine wakuja kanisa for the sake of it. Ask your neighbor, why do you come to church?
Why do you come to church?
Do you come for the sake of it?
For the sake of it.
Ndio kuna mtu alikuta wazazi wakienda kanisa inaitwa Methodist. Alikuta wazazi wanaendanga, akapelekwa Methodist. Akakuwa kiwe ni me. Ndio kuna mtu wa kichakani. Hata alisahau Mungu anakaa aje. Lakini anakuambia mimi ni kishika. Kwa kanisa ya Methodist. Awili ingine. Uwe mtu inakuambia jambo moja. Alienda kanisani for the sake of it. And that's the problem we have as a republic. We have members who are in churches for the sake of it. They do not believe in the power of the God of the church. They don't believe in the power of the God of the church. We rule principalities and authorities on our knees. Amen. We rule principalities and authorities on our knees. Now, the more we talk, the more times we lose our feet. The more you talk, the more you lose your because of discouragement. Because of? Because of what we are send your voice aside. Most of the talks that people are having due to this kind of thing, they are helping us to use our faith more. See you? So this is the same thing about the apostle, 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 the same thing about the apostle. That's the church. Now if that's the church, the voice of this kind of thing, where do you think this nation will start on Tuesday, next week, Keshokuto? Kanisa nitasimama wapi? Wale Wakristo wengi, wakishapiga kura, warudi kwa nyumba. Atarudi kwa nyumba na afungulie TV na aanze kupigia marafiki zake simu. Wajificha haraka iwezekanavyo. Ni wachache watapiga kura, waende kwa nyumba waweke song ya praise. Wakisema, ametenda mema. Ametenda? Ametenda? Hello? If we can find the joy of the Lord in the midst of our discouragement, we can find the strength of seeing the result. If we can find a place for the joy of the Lord in our hearts, even in the midst of discouragement, that joy can give the strength of knowing the result. Amen? That is straight alone. The word of God. Romans chapter 10 verse 17. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. Ndio maana Yesu alipojua ya kwamba mawazo yao imeondoka katika neno, alianza kuwarejesha kwa neno. Alianza kuwarejesha kwa neno. Akawapeleka kwa neno pole 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 mpaka wakafika. Wakifika anawaambia, si wadugu tuonane. Wanamwambia tafadhali, spend the night with us. Spend the night. Yesu alipoingia pale, akachukua mkate akashukuru. Alipoufuta, akawapa, macho yao yakafunguka. Akili zao zikafunguka. They understanding was open. May our understanding be open this day. May our understanding be open this day. Praise God. And this understanding is coming to a level whereby we know that what is impossible with man is possible with God. Amen. Coming to a point of understanding that He alone is the Alpha and Omega. He brings to to an end, and he creates a beginning from the end. Are we together? This understanding, if we have money for Kujoya Papa as a church, we can start and lift an altar for God, pertaining it, and declare there shall be peace. And declare there shall be peace. Acha kuangalia biashara yako. Look at the entire nation. You know, this season we are very selfish. Nachukua gari yako unaenda kuficha. Nagonyana pa kuficha nani? Sirizoni niliuliza. Najua naweza chukua yangu nipeleke pale baba mkubwa anafanya kazi hapo kwa polisi. Alisema ikiwa hapo iko safe. Iko safe. Nagonyana baba mkubwa akupeleke. Ano, isawa, unaweza funga kwako, utoroki wende ushago, na mwenye ushago kwa nilewa malale, ataenda wati. Najiwe ni kusema karukua mwichi yako, ni kusema kinyoga na pende zaki. Zaki. It's time we lifted Jehovah God upon this republic and declare there shall be peace this week. Praise God. There shall be peace this week. This explains why Jesus had opened the word for them. Their real problem was not in their heads, but in their hearts. Shida yao haikuwa kwa mawazo, ilikuwa kwenye roho. Ilikuwa kwenye. No wonder tunaambiwa, above everything else, guard your heart. Guard your heart. Shida saizi tulionayo, hata kama kanisa, si kwa mawazo. Ni roho zetu. Roho. For out of the heart, there is a way of life. Now, according to the book of Luke, chapter 24, and verse 25. Luke 24, verse 25. He said to them, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Wow. How foolish you are, and how slow to heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. He was addressing a discouraged lot. Two disciples, very discouraged. And I will say, niaje mkona uchika. Niaje roho zenu zimepungukiwa kwa kuamini lililo neno na manabii. Halo, lililo neno na manabii. Might you be one of the two disciples this afternoon? Very discouraged? Having forgotten everything that the prophet has spoken about this nation? Halo? Are we there? Wengine wametazama vifo ambavyo vimetokea. There has been a lot of deaths towards this election. That alone. Imetia watu uoga mwingi sana. Na kweli tunafaa kuogopa. But he has not given us a spirit of fear. He has not given us a spirit of fear. Amen? Are we there? How slow of us to believe what the Lord, what God has spoken pertaining to this nation. We may not have been there praying for this republic, but there have been men and women crisscrossing the 47 counties, lifting an altar for God. Amen. Lifting an altar for God. Are we there? We may not have been there, but there has been men and women traversing the 47 counties, praying for this republic. The others who have been in forest and in mountains, fasting, lifting this nation before God. And God says, for the sake of one, I shall not be strong. For the sake of one, I shall not be strong. If my people who are called by my name
They leave their evil ways and they call unto me. I will hear from heaven and I will heal their land. I will heal. Are we called by his name? Are we called by his name? Are there some of us who have been perfecting their ways by detaching themselves from evil? Then, if such people call unto him, he will hear and he will heal. And so today, we are going to call upon the name of Jehovah God to heal this republic. We are going to call upon his name to heal this republic like we've never done before. Yabana nisema wabaki. Kwa sababu wanyenda shule last week, we even prayed for our church. Do you remember? I think less than that, yaongea kabisa. Nataimu, ama ni nani? Ama ni kendi? One of them. And truly, truly, our church has been a battlefield for the last 2 weeks. People going to court, conference, as a mission, and there was a lot of fear, a lot of discouragement. But at the 11th hour, God opened the way. At the 11th hour, the judges dismissed the injunction. And therefore, the church was at liberty to go to the annual conference and to continue with the business. They gave it our enemy to occur at the camp to talk about some rain. Here, pray, here. Paka juicy. The 11th, and as that was happening, I remembered when we were praying for the elections of the church before teenagers were officially. And I said, now that God, you've given us victory, please, we need also to call upon your name again for Tuesday. Amen? Ni jambo baya sana, kukutana hapa, after 2 weeks, wengine wakiwa wamevunjwa mikono, wengine miguu, wengine majumba zikichomwa, wengine sijui nini, wengine waanze kukupatia prayer request mtoto wako akipotea, sijui yako wapi. That is not. That is not emotion. We are so much ahead of us that we can't afford to lose it for it. Amen? I am so much ahead of me because the clock is ticking. Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. I yet to soak. And I am an assignment. I am an assignment. Come on, I am one. And I can't afford to lose it. Now, all these disciples needed was a fresh understanding of God's word. They needed a fresh understanding of God's word. And that is what Jesus gave unto them. And now I pray that he's going to find it worthy to give us a fresh understanding of his word. Amen? A fresh understanding of his word. Unless we come to that point of having a fresh understanding of his word, then we won't know how to stand in the gap. The other day we were speaking about watchmen. We were speaking about watchmen. It was the last time we had a fellowship. We spoke about we are called to be a watchman. And this is the day calling upon the watchmen to arise so that we may perform our noble duty.
Amen.
Are we there? All the watchmen today, the watchmen in FCA Umoja Bayole, are going to take their positions and pray for this republic. Are we there? Amana, to make it easy to even to make it to the back of Anissa. A little do we know that someone in our midst holds the destiny of this republic. You don't have to do it. Unaweza unapeka na watu tu shaka na papa ile ya kukaa. But you never know who you are seated next to. You may be seated next to a pastor who holds the destiny of this city. Amen? You might be
to a person ambaye Mungu amempa kibali cha kutabiria mikupa mikavu ya taifa la Kenya kejiwa lota haya. Because every church has those people, including ours. Look at your name with suspicion, as if you're suspecting that they are the ones. Just look at them suspiciously, as if they are the ones. Tell them you might be the one. Tell them you might be the one. Mwambie vizuri,
you might be the one.
Mwambie, for that reason, you are going to take your position. Not tomorrow,
not later,
but now.
Amen?
And that's what we are going to do. There is no other place I would have been than this place to be. Because this is a place we are experiencing an open heaven. An open heaven. That's what I'm asking my body. The heaven is open. If we don't have the corner of Pita, we can't have Pita. Smile. Now, I know some of us have never prayed for 3 minutes. The others who have never prayed for 5 minutes. The others, the only prayer you know is.